So first of all, a geometry creation, then mesh, setup, solution and result. So one by one, we are going to discuss all these six parameters. So first of all, I will create a geometry or a base meter. So the design model has been selected. So check it out, X, Y and Z. So these are X, Y and Z, so respective axis I have, X1 red, Y green, Z it is blue. So first of all set the units, so I am specifying the units in centimeter over here. So we are understanding the fluid flow simulation which is taking place through a RPS meter. So first of all I will create a primitive, that is a cylinder. In Z direction I want, so I will say somewhere around 150 over here. If I want this to be at center, so I will specify this as minus 75. So your object will be at the center. Now next thing, make it add to frozen. So this is this is a solid object which has been generated. So I don't want solid object, I want this object to be hollow from inside. So I will take the option which is as a thin surface. So let's make it generate. So this is how the object will be created. Now one more time, orifice is a small opening through which the fluid flow are taking place. So I am going to create one more primitive over here as a cylinder. So you can see the wireframe model which has been generated over here. Again make it add to frozen over here. Then in the Z component which you have specified 10, I will specify this as a minus 5 so that it will be at the center. Now here I am specifying thin surface, yes. I will specify some value which is 6 or 7 over here so that it will become hollow from inside. Now just check it out how the object is. So this is how the portion which I have generated from inside. So orifice is a small opening through which the fluid flows are taking place. So first of all we have taken cylinder, second one also we have taken another cylinder. Now you can check out there are two part, two bodies. First one solid, this is also solid. Now what I will do is I will make a boolean operation and I will unite both of the bodies. So make it apply and make it generate. So the object has been generated. Now you can see one part, one body. Now the next step will be we need to specify the fluid zone over here. So go to tool, then select fill operation, select the internal surfaces. So this is the first portion I have selected, this is second. Try to select the portion which is available at inside also, this one and this one. So in this way I have selected all the portion where I want to specify the fluid. So make it generate. Now you can see two part, two bodies. Here it is solid, it is also showing solid, it is showing a fluid. So we need to rename this as a fluid. So this will be your fluid zone. So I have specified this as a fluid zone. Now next process will be to do the meshing. Next one, after the meshing you need to specify the name selection, inlet, outlet, and then we need to apply the boundary condition. So as of now the fluid flow through venture meter, so we are done with the geometry. Now next part will be your meshing. So going back to your mesh over here, so make it edit. So this is how the object which is available in front of us. Now on the mesh I will just generate mesh. So this will be the default mesh which will be generated. So I am going to use the default mesh because it is generated by computer itself. So the time required for simulation will also be less. But again we are actually compromising with the accuracy of the result. But just for visualization of, we can say, the simulation, I will just specify here inlet, outlet and wall. So select this as inlet over here. So this is my inlet. Second one, this will be my outlet. And third one will be my wall. So I am specifying this as a wall. So this three part which I have specified with the name selection, inlet, outlet and wall. Now one more time, make it update. Now you can see the mesh translation to Fluent is successful. So once this message is obtained, you can close your meshing. So go back to the mesh. In front of mesh it is right click. In front of geometry is also right click. So whatever till now we have done is correct. Now we'll shift to the setup. So make it double precision. Depending on your core of your system, you can select a suitable. I have 10, so I selected this. So start the process. Now here we'll apply the boundary condition. And second thing what we will do, we'll start performing the calculations here. So you can see a blue arrow and red arrow. So the blue arrow indicates the inlet, the red arrow indicates your outlet. So first of all, specify the gravity. Where I am specifying the gravity, -9.81. You can just check, this is a positive direction. So I am specifying the gravity in the negative direction. So model, I am not changing anything. Instead of fluid, I will specify there as a water. So drag down below, you will get water liquid over here. Copy, then close this. So close this box also, so you can see water liquid available. Now you can go for the boundary conditions. Now which boundary condition you can go for? You have to go for the inlet. So I am specifying some velocity at the inlet. So I am just specifying a small velocity over here, a 0.1 meter per second. Now you can close this. Now next thing, after this, go to the reference values. So reference values, we need to specify from where to start, as the computer needs to be told from where to start. So this is a reference zone we are specifying as a fluid. Next part will be for initialization. So we have to go for standard initialization. Start it from the inlet, make it initialize over here. Then go for the calculation activities. Auto save your work so that even if some power failures are taking place, you can recover your work. So go to run calculation. Here, specify the number of iterations which you are expected to do. Now next thing, go to the graphics, select a path line. So here you are observing particle variable, specify velocity. Where you want to observe this velocity, inlet, outlet and wall. So save display over here and you can close this. So these are how the things are been done. Now it's time to go for the calculation. So I will start the calculation here. So depending on your system configuration, it will require time. Otherwise it will be completed within few minutes. So you will see such graph has been coming out. So you will get some message that calculation is complete at the end of whatever calculation you have done. So we'll just wait. Okay, once this is done, you will get message that its calculation is complete. Okay, such message is obtained over here. So we'll just check it out in front of setup is also right click over here. So I'm just going to close this Fluent and we'll proceed for my last step, that is result. So let's move to the result over here. So this is what a post processing which we have. So this is how the object which has been created. I'm selecting inlet, outlet, wall and wall solid. So on each and every case, I am giving some specification in terms of transparency 0.9. Same way I will go for outlet. So we'll set transparency equal to 0.9. Then wall also I will specify transparency 0.9 over here. And wall solid also I will specify transparency 0.9. So make it apply over here. Okay, one more time. This is 0.9. Make it apply before proceeding. So at inlet, so specify 0.9 and then make it apply. Otherwise it will not be applied. Same way here also 0.9 over here. Make it apply. So if you don't want to see the wireframe model, you can avoid the wireframe model also. So depending on what you want to visualize, accordingly we can proceed for. So first of all, I will select streamline over here. So make it okay. So we have to start from inlet, then make it apply over here. Now you can see some path lines are being produced. And now it's time to run the animation over here. I'll just check it out, streamline over here. So make this slow so that you can visualize it in a better way over here. So you can see the fluid particles which are coming out through small portion. The velocities are found to be a higher value over there, and you can just see the fluid flow simulation which are taking place through orifice meter. So velocities are increased over there. I will just slightly do some modification and we'll come back. So this is a legend view. So which type of legend view you want, accordingly you can say. If I want this is to be fixed one, you can just check it out over here. So you can change the size also here. Then you can change this precision, you can change these values to 10 so that we can visualize more results over here. You can just check it out. Then additionally, if you want to put out some name also, this can also be done by using this option ABC. I will just try to show you how to prepare the charts for the same. So I'm going for the chart option available. Then data series, I'm going to take as a streamline over here. X component, I'm going to take as a distance of my object. That is, my object is in Z direction. So I'm considering this is Z. On Y axis, I'm specifying the velocity over here. So we'll just check what will happen to your velocity. So you can see the velocities are found to be maximum at the part which is considered to be the central part of your object. Say if you are considering your axis, so where your axis was, the axis was your at center. So accordingly we say the maximum velocities will be obtained over there. So you are aware that you have specified the axis at the central. So Z component we have considered. So with that we are getting the simulation over here. So if you see the chart viewer, what you will see, the velocities are maximum at this point, and then again it drops. So we had the object which we have generated. Initially the velocities was less, then velocities were maximum, again the velocity has decreased. So in this way we can do the fluid flow simulation for our orifice meter. You can just check at this part the velocities has reached to a higher value. If you want to save this work, you can just go to the option and save with respect to whatever file you want, whether you want to save as a video file, whether you want to save some other file, you can do that. So this is in general regarding to the fluid flow simulation which are taking place through the orifice meter. Thank you.